Today we are going to make something like this. How to make an animation using Stable Diffusion. Common sense made simple. Let's do this.
Here we are in the Diffusion Stable Diffusion notebook by Diffusion. I did some minor manipulations to the notebook. This will be available for members for download if you want to download the complete version. So let's get started. So first off, if you don't know about how to use notebooks, I'll post a link somewhere in this corner for a tutorial to show you the very basics, just the ropes of a notebook so you can do more advanced notebooks like this. Okay, so first off, I always like to do this section here just to give me more space to see, but this is the most important part here. You need to get this CKPT file and put it in your Google Drive, or else this will not work. Unlike other notebooks where you download everything by ticking these circles, this you actually have to do a little bit of work on your own. You can download at this link, which I'll put in the description, and also leave other links for direct download. So let's get started. First, take your GPU. I have a Pro Plus account, so normally I can get a V100 or A100 if I'm really lucky. V100 is great, but even if you have a regular account, you can still do all this for free, or I suggest the regular Pro account. So click on this, and now it's gonna connect to your Google Drive.
Common sense made simple.
Allow permission. Now this is going to take a few minutes, so I'm probably gonna speed this part up, but you're just gonna tick all this, click this, and after all this loads, we'll get into the animation section here. But first off, as you can see, it offers none, which would just give you one image, which is really amazing, the power of Stable Diffusion. 2D animation, which is what we'll be covering today. And very soon, I'm gonna release a video input video. Right now, I have a video input tutorial for Disco Diffusion. If you want, I'll put a link to that. Interpolation, we're not gonna get into that right now. So let me speed this up. Now you see, for this instance, I chose this model, and then you have to make sure this is the one you download. I downloaded this assuming it was better and tested it out, and I didn't like the results. So I'm just gonna stick with SD, which stands for Stable Diffusion, version 1. And for all I know, in a week, they're gonna have a 5 and a 6 and a 7, but right now, this is the best one. So I downloaded that. And it does take a little while to download. So once you have that downloaded, you'll put it into your drive, which I'll show you here. Now, load that. And this is the option too, if you want to use your CPU. I always use the CUDA. I feel like that's faster. But see how it's, I placed this file here in my drive, AI models, and that's where it is. All right, I sped that part up a little bit, but it took less than a minute for this section. Now let's get to the fun part. So, like I said, we're gonna be doing 2D animation. And frame-wise, I mean, this all is your preference. I just put 1,000. I mean, that's good for now. If you have an exact amount, depending if you're gonna, your final output will be 60 frames per second or 10 frames per second. That's all preference. Now here, the angle, this will make the video spin and zoom will go in. X and Y, obviously, will move it up and
left,
down.
Right, left,
see the zero here? You can add keyframes, for example. If you do 100 and add, say, 1.01, and don't hit whatever I just hit there. But yeah, so after 100 frames, it'll start moving at, that speed, etc. For this instance, I'm just gonna keep it. I'm not going to keyframe any of the animation, but I like to do a little bit of an angle move. So I do 1.02. And for the zoom, I usually slow it down to 1.03. I feel in general, it's a little too fast for my preference, but it all depends what you want. And I also usually take my final output and put it into After Effects when I'm done, so I have more control over the speed and smoothing, etc. So X and Y, I'm not going to mess with that, but that'll make it go up and down if you're interested. Color coherence, I keep it to the match frame. I put it on none, ran some experiments, and after like 30 or 40 frames, it just started getting really saturated and strange. So I leave it at match frame. Frame noise, I don't touch. For the previous frame strength, I just take off the 5. I don't know if it's because of my OCD or whatever, but I feel that's a good setting. If you go under 0.5, it'll start looking, your frames will start looking so differently that it becomes more like a time lapse. I actually did an experiment using Logan or Wolverine from the X-Men, and you would think I just took a bunch of paintings and did them back to back to back. Video input, I'll be covering in my next tutorial. You don't have to worry about that or that. Now, interpolate frames, it's set to 4. I turn this off because I feel it makes it blurry and smooth. And interpolation in general, I mean, if I need to do any of that, I do it in post in Adobe After Effects. But if that's the look you're going for, you want it to be more smooth, I would play around with this. But I personally don't use it. I don't like it. Now, here's the most exciting part, the prompts. Now, this area is if you're doing a single image, so we're going to ignore all this right now. This is what's going to animate, and this is the sample. I never even ran this because, I mean, trending on ArtStation, I mean, that's so 2021.
Oh my god!
And beautiful apple, blah, blah, blah. For this instance, I'm not going to animate. See, normally you can have the prompt shift, say in 10 frames, then 100 frames, etc., and it'll continue. But it blends so quick, I've done it. It's like you blink your eye and you're like, whoa, this is just too much going on. So I'm going to eliminate that for now. Now, I've been playing with prompts since the code came out a few days ago. And I mean, I kind of liked how this results came out. You know, Cthulhu, everyone loves Cthulhu. He's in Cray, if you're unfamiliar, he's a fictional horror entity with a lot of tentacles. And then I add detailed oil on canvas just to give it a more realistic look, painterly like type look. And Mike Mignola is a comic book artist, if you're unfamiliar. He did Hellboy and stuff like that. I feel these keywords, award-winning art and 4K/8K help, but I've ran some experiments where I noticed they didn't do very much, but I like to keep them in there either way, so here they are. But same time, we don't know the results. I'm going to be running a random seed, so that's the fun part about it. It's like an abstract art slot machine, but so we'll see if the results will be live. Now, batch name, this is what it will save under in your Google Drive. I'm just going to call it
Cthulhu. I swear in the squid beak of Lord Cthulhu.
Mignola. Say, just leave all this. End samples I played with, I didn't notice much of a difference. Width and height, I would like to go 704 by 704. I feel the max that it lets you do is 1024, but the results start mirroring themselves and it looks strange. Your best bet, this is my favorite size, and then I upscale it a little bit using Topaz, and but it's all depends on the results. I'm using a square output too, just for this example. You can stretch it out different ways, but I don't know, this will extend the time and the render as well. All right, this is for initial image. If you want to use an image, initial image, and strength is how much it will change each frame. Well, we're not going to use that for now. Now, seed, this is more detailed. I keep it at -1, so when the initial frame starts, it will be a whatever seed it decides. But this is what affects it now, the iteration. So now say the seed is 1001, then every frame then it'll be 1002, 1003, 1004, for example. So you could fix it and it'll stay on the same frame, but if you have your match previous frame above 0.5, you're just gonna get the same image over and over and over. It's pointless for an animation. Now random, it'll jump around a little bit. I personally feel that the iteration is the best. Now for sample KMLS, I've tested all these out. I mean, I don't notice the difference. Everyone says this is the best, so I leave it at this. Steps, you can max out at 250, which is overkill, I think. I mean, 100 to 130, depending how long your prompt is usually perfect. But the thing is, when you look at previous frame strength, this is gonna deduct from your steps from each frame. So 0.6, I will get 100 steps per frame. Only the first frame, the initial frame, will use 250, as you'll see when we run it. Now scale, you know, typical like guidance scale, CVG scale, I always feel 13 is a decent number, 12, 13. If you go too low, it won't match your prompt. If you go too high, it just gets messy. Now ETA, in Dream Studio, they leave it at a 75, but I've run the same prompt and same settings and I noticed really no difference. So pretty much that's it. Now let's run. You're gonna be seeing the results for the first time, just as I am, because it's could be different. Oh no. Okay, let's go back and make sure we checked everything. Animation. See the green check, it means we're all good. Our prompt is good, commas are in. Loaded. Now here's the fun part. Obviously, I forgot to check these earlier. So this is going to be a surprise result for me too, because I didn't use the same seed, but as you can see, it picked a random seed. So it picked 8, 6, 1, 6, 7, 8, 0, 1, 0. So another thing to remember with this is, because it doesn't have a resume run similar to Disco Diffusion, where if it crashes or you lose your Wi-Fi, you're like, oh no, I lost my sequence or whatever. So now, as long as you have this number, which will save in your Google Drive, you can start again from using the same prompts and setting, either from the beginning using this, because it's gonna iterate and go up one every frame, or say it crashed at frame 8055, you would come back and start there, or you know, it'll do the same iteration. But I mostly recommend, if you need to rerun it, I'm sure they'll add a resume run feature at some point, or Disco Diffusion, I'm sure, is gonna add Stable Diffusion as one of their model options in the near future, if they haven't already by the time it's come out. So see, now it ran the first 250 steps and you get this image, which, I mean, it's pretty cool in my opinion, you know. And Mike Mignola has these really thick lines in his designs and his comic book art, so it gives it that look. And that's frame one. Now you'll see when it hits the next frame, when it hits 100 steps, it'll move slightly depending on the animation. So I zoomed in a little and I turned a little. So now at this point, I mean, I'm gonna run it. I usually like to do my animations 30 frames per second, and then I play around in After Effects to get a more choppy look or smoother look with posterized time, etc., those types of effects. But if you're working right out of the box, you know, you set it to however many frames you want. Say you want it 10 frames a second, you want 5 seconds, then you're gonna do 50 frames. So I'm gonna run this just to do, say, 100 frames to get an example so I can show you the next steps. But I'll speed this part up, but I'll leave it time lapse so you can kind of see it changing. Okay, I'm back. I almost don't want it to stop because I see it doing some really interesting stuff, because as I said earlier, this is all just new to me too, because the experiments I ran previously, I used the same settings and same text prompt, but you know, it's a random seed, so you never know what you're gonna come up with. But for now, I'm just gonna stop it here just to show the example. But that took a little bit over an hour. I mean, it all depends on the size. You can make this smaller, 512 by 512, it'll go much faster. And of course the GPU, you know, you get with the cloud will also make a difference. So now there's two ways to turn this into an animation. I mean, if you use third-party software like Adobe After Effects, Blender, Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve, you would take the PNG sequence that's saved in your Google Drive and go from there. But if you want to do it right out of the box, they have this option here. And set your frames per second. I like 30, but just for this instance, we'll go 12. And tick on that, and it'll take all your frames and turn it into a little video, which we'll be saving into your drive under this Stable Diffusion, etc., you know. But overall, you know, I like to go 300 frames minimum, because I also take my frames as a PNG sequence and bring it into After Effects, and I do additional things, including slowing it down and smoothing things out and etc., playing with the frame rates further. But in this case, anybody can do this. You don't need to go to school to learn animation and film like I did. And anybody learns how to run a notebook, you could do this, and it's 100% free. What if you want an NFT, or you want to just be creative and whatever? I mean, it's so fascinating and so powerful. It's as a traditional digital animator, seeing this is just so insane. So this is what the notebook produced for me at 12 frames per second, just to get an example. And that's right out of the box. You can take this, download it, it's yours. Boom, that's it. I don't know, eat some psilocybin and just loop it all day, or, you know. But I mean, that's pretty much it. So I hope this helped you out. I mean, tag me, I'd love to see what you create with this. And if you're a member, I'll give you access to these notebooks direct, including other features. And overall, I'd love to see what you create with all this stuff. And you know, have a great day or night or whatever. Goodbye.